looks pretty good. Now, you could also take your pipette and make lines like this. You put it on one side and go across. And again, and again, and again. Well, that's kind of interesting. Now I'm gonna try a spiral. It's a work of art. And you can actually lift it up slightly and move it, and it stays in place. If you tilt it too far, it starts to move. Now, if you want to put a little bit more color, you can. Let's see what happens if
I'd like to put, let's say,
viscosity.
Maybe blue in the center.
Viscosity is the thickness of a liquid.
Now there's green left. There we go. Now what do we do?
Put a lot of blue. See, in science, you can experiment. You can try something new and see what happens. That looks pretty good. This experiment works because this liquid is really thick. When it's really thick, we say it has high viscosity, like honey. And when it's really thin, like water, it has low viscosity. Viscosity is actually a scale with many things in between, like chocolate syrup. It's somewhere between water and honey. The liquid we are working with has sodium alginate in it. Sodium alginate comes from seaweed, and it makes the liquid really, really thick with high viscosity. In fact, it moves slowly around your pipette, causing most of it to stay in place, and just the food coloring gets dragged through. Okay, on to the second part. We can move our artwork to the side. And next, we're gonna make our sodium alginate liquid a certain color. Which color? Blue.
Right blue.
Kind of my favorite color, or tied with orange. All right, here we go. Here's one. Oh, it got caught in a bubble. Just poke that out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect. Now we need to mix it up, but it requires a special technique.
16, 17, 18,
Watch.
19, 20.
You can put the cap back on and make sure it's kind of tight. See, if we just shake it up, we're going to get lots of bubbles in it. We don't want bubbles. So you're going to flip it over like this, over and over again. You can see it's starting to mix slowly because it's very viscous. I'm going to do this 20 times. That was 21. That's okay. So now our sodium alginate is a certain color. Now, to do a chemical reaction, we usually need two different things to mix together. So let's get that other thing ready. Place the two plastic cups next to each other on the mat. We'll take our liquid out of this bottle, and we're going to pour it into a cup, like this. It might take a second because it's so thick. That's good enough. All right, now a chemical reaction is when two things mix together and it makes something new. So this is one thing, now we gotta prepare the other. For that, you'll need some water. You can use a cup or a pitcher, or just fill up this cup.
Can you get me a cup? I'm gonna save some of this. We saved some of this, baby.
3/4 of the way with water. Cold water is best. Now we're going to mix in a chemical into this water.
3/4
It's this one here.
That's
in this
enough.
Tube.
It's too much.
And it's called calcium lactate gluconate. Whoa, that's a big word. But this is basically calcium, which we need for our bones. And in fact, this is used as a vitamin. Now we're going to pour this calcium into the water. But as soon as we pour it, we have to start mixing. If you wait, it's going to clump up. The experiment will still work, but not as well. Okay, watch. I pour it in like this, and then I start mixing right away. So we're going to mix for 10 seconds. You don't have to mix it hard. No splashing. Perfect.
If there's a little clumping at the bottom, that's okay.
Now for the last part, We have to mix the blue liquid into the clear one. Mm. To do that, we will use this. I call it a plunger. It just sucks up liquid.
Syringe?
So watch. We're going to put this under the blue liquid, just a little bit like this, not all the way to the bottom. And then you're going to pull it up until it gets to the 10 mark, like that. You can see it's numbered. Now that we have the blue liquid in this plunger, we're going to ooze it into the clear one. You hold it just above, and you ooze it in like this. You can see something is starting to happen. Perfect. And now, we have to wait just 10 seconds for the chemical reaction to happen. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now watch. Just take your
it's bubbling.
And reach in and just grab a little piece. And watch. You can pull it out. And look what we made. It's like a worm. And it keeps going and going and going and going. Neat. You can hold it with two hands. This is safe. It jiggles and moves. Whoa, it broke. But that's okay. This is neat. You can touch it, examine it. What's cool is if you squeeze it, you can tell that it's still liquid on the inside. You can see that the bubbles move inside.
You want me to make more?
In fact, you can break the strand.
You were trying to. Oh, yeah. I wonder if you can use one of those colors out of the dish.
Out by squeezing it.
Okay, you want to test?
This time, instead of making a strand, I'm going to make little drops.
That's on, like, for infinity.
And it actually makes little infinity. Drops in the same way. Instead of a strand,
this one's ready.
It's a drop. Look, I have one right here. And I can pop it.
Oh, look.
Ooh, that's satisfying. What we just did is a chemical reaction. Remember, that's when we mix two chemicals together and it makes something.
This one doesn't work as well, but it works.
Do they get some green, and then you can make little drops in there?
And it formed a gel. That gel is made out of calcium alginate. That gel only forms where the two liquids touch. So it first forms on the outside of the liquid tube you made. But at first, that gel coating is very thin and breakable. And that's why we wait 10 seconds so it gets thicker and thicker so we can pick it up. Thick enough so that we can play with it. And if it keeps sitting in the liquid longer, the whole thing will turn into gel, and there'll be no liquid in the middle at all. This material has some real-life uses. In some countries, they use the same ingredients to make fancy foods, like fruit juices made into a jelly ball using calcium alginate. This material is also used to help wounds heal faster.
Look at this, Mom. How big this one is!
Liquids, so you can continue to experiment as much as you want. And lastly, let me show you an advanced technique now that we've practiced. In fact, you could take this liquid right from the cup and pour it in one thin strand to get the same effect. So liquid pouring and becoming the worm. Let's see if I'm any good.